Testament biblical hero who interpreted visions and dreams about future prophetic events. Today, the Book of Daniel, deconstructed by end times expert Ron Rhodes. What lies ahead in the last days? Next on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith and world events surrounding Israel. The Book of Daniel is a 2,500-year-old book found in the Old Testament and is part of the section known as the Nevi'im, the writings of the prophets. Daniel's packed full of prophecy. Now, many of these prophecies have come to pass: the destruction of Jerusalem, the return from the Babylonian captivity, and the rebuilding of the temple, and then later the defilement of the temple in an act called the Abomination of Desolation. But many of Daniel's prophecies are yet to be fulfilled, and some that have been will likely be repeated in a time known as the end of the age or the time of the end. Are we in that time now? Today's guest will help us sort through this amazing book. Please welcome back a longtime friend to this program, teacher, author, and prophecy expert, Dr. Ron Rhodes.
Good to see you. Good to see you again.
Wow. I have so many questions for you, some that we won't get to, because I absolutely love the Book of Daniel, and it is, as I introduced, packed with prophecy. Why did you choose Daniel, going through all the books of the Bible, to write next? Because you've done Genesis, you've done Revelation, you've done over 70 books, but you picked Daniel now. Why?
I picked Daniel because I think that Daniel is the book that we need today to help us through a lot of the crises that we are facing in the world today. In this country, we're engulfed in pagan religion, and it's increasing by the day, really. I think that many Christians are having a faith crisis. There's a lot of disillusionment out there in many Christians. And I think a lot of what Daniel has to say to us can meet many of those kinds of needs. Daniel is a great example in terms of how to live a life of faith in God, how to deal with the problem of evil, which is pretty predominant today. And I also think that Daniel helps us to have a excited concept about God. You know, we've talked about the living God. And that's really what we need to hear about today.
We sure do. When I read Daniel, when I read books connected with the Babylonian captivity, I think of the times we live in now, because America's changed.
Yes,
radically. The world has radically changed, and there is a war against people of faith. There's a war against biblical values.
There is. And the thing about Daniel is that he was not only an open witness to God and a defender of the truth, but have you noticed how respectful and kind he always was in dealing with people who really weren't believers in the true God? It really reminds me of the New Testament teaching that we're to always be ready with an answer, but with gentleness and respect.
But even the king, the king respected him so much because he honored authority, but he lived out his faith in the living God, in the God
of
Israel, in the midst of a very conflicted culture.
And I think that's what we need today. I think there's a lot of Christians kind of standing back and cowering in fear. It's not just the paganism in our country, but you've got the new atheists and all these other people who are screaming at Christians. We need a baptism of boldness to fall upon the church, the same kind of boldness that was on Daniel. And of course, there's one reason why Daniel was bold. It was because of his faith in the living God. You see, I think that our level of boldness telling the truth about Jesus is directly related, to our sense of having a fellowship with the living God,
wow,
who is always
that's convicting.
With us. Yeah.
Let me jump ahead and talk about the idea of the end of the age or the end of days. Can you define that for us?
Well, we're talking about the end times or the last days or the latter days or the eschatological end. I mean, there's a lot of terms that kind of mean the same thing. And we're talking about the end of human history as we know it. The fact of the matter is that Daniel, not just Daniel, but Daniel among a number of prophets, give us insights on what the last days are going to look like. I like to view prophecy as God's intel in advance.
Good.
God's intel in advance. After all, God is the one who knows the end from the beginning. The past, present, and future are simultaneously present to him. So he understands it all, and he declares it to the prophets, and the prophets tell it to us. That's the wonder about Daniel, because Daniel tells us God's intel in advance. And one of the things that Daniel focuses on is the tribulation period, known elsewhere in the Old Testament as the time of Jacob's trouble. You know, there's going to be a lot of pain and suffering during that time. But he also talks a lot about the Antichrist figure that will come into power in the end times. And that Antichrist is not some institution of evil or some impersonal allegory. It's going to be a real person that comes into power.
By the way, I want people to understand this is not about proclaiming doom and gloom.
No.
This is about the hope of the establishment of God's kingdom and the blessing of knowing him and being in his hands.
Well, you're exactly right, and you're just reading my mind as you're going along. It just shows we're in tune with each other. You know, when Daniel has these dreams and these prophecies that he's giving, you know, he talks about the rise of the revived Roman Empire, and he talks about the Antichrist, but then he talks about how God is establishing his kingdom. And we also read about the Ancient of Days bestowing dominion upon the Son of Man. That's talking about Yeshua. What all of that is building up to is that at the second coming, Christ will overcome the Antichrist. He will rescue Israel that's just converted in the wilderness. They've cried out to their divine Messiah, and the Messiah comes and delivers them from the Antichrist. And then Christ sets up the millennial kingdom. And then all the land promises in the Abrahamic covenant are fulfilled to Israel.
We call it the Messianic Age in the Jewish community.
It's awesome. And of course, the throne promises given in the Davidic covenant will come to fruition. Christ will reign on a literal throne of David in Jerusalem during the millennial kingdom. And then, wonder of wonders, the eternal state begins after that.
Yeah, it's a eschatology of victory, folks.
It is.
Let me jump to where we left off yesterday of a topic of great interest, I think, to many people watching, the rebuilding of a third temple.
Yes.
Now, I introduced that many of the prophecies of Daniel have come to pass.
Right.
There was an abomination of desolation. There was a rebuilding of the temple after the Babylonian captivity, but some of these things will be repeated. Some of these are yet for the future. So talk about how all that works together. For those that look at the abomination of desolation and say it's already happened, it's a thing of the past.
Well, of course, Epiphanes did slaughter a pig in the temple, and so you've got that. But I think that Epiphanes was a type of Antichrist. In other words, he foreshadowed the coming of a future, more powerful leader known as the Antichrist.
So history repeats itself.
History repeats itself. We, you know, we see in 2 Thessalonians 2, and in the book of Revelation, Revelation 13, the Antichrist is going to actually set up an image of himself within the temple, and that's going to defile the temple. And in Matthew 24, Jesus says, if you live in Jerusalem at that time, get out quick, because things are about to get real bad in Jerusalem. That's when the Antichrist is claiming to be God. And you got to think about this, Jonathan. You know, Jesus Christ is the Son of God. The Antichrist is the son of perdition. Jesus is the Lamb. The Antichrist is the beast. Jesus is energized by the Holy Spirit. The Antichrist is energized by the unholy spirit, Satan. Jesus is slain for the people. The Antichrist is the slayer of the people. Jesus humbled himself and became a man. The Antichrist exalts himself to godhood. Jesus cleansed the temple. The Antichrist defiles the temple, like we were just talking about.
You have spent quite a bit of time in this book. If the abomination of desolation is yet for the future, it requires a rebuilt temple and a rebuilt Holy of Holies.
Right.
How do you see that playing out? Because we have a very, very, probably the, one guest says, Dr. Randall Price, this is the most disputed real estate in the world.
It is the most disputed real estate, but here's how I see it coming down. There is going to be a massive Ezekiel invasion, and I'm basing this on Ezekiel 38 and 39. And the scriptures are very clear about what those nations are.
I'm being told that we have to take a break. This is the right.
Stay tuned.
You've got to stay tuned.
More to come.
And find out how this is going to all play out. So don't go anywhere. Lots more with Dr. Ron Rhodes. If you want to find out how the temple's going to be rebuilt, you have to stay with us.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming Messiah to the world, to the Jew first, and also to the nations.
One key way we do this is by providing life-saving humanitarian aid to some of the poorest people in the world. In helping them, we share God's love and the good news of Yeshua, Jesus. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Barangwa, Zimbabwe, the Lemba. This faithful yet forgotten people have ties to the ancient people of Israel, the priestly tribe of Aaron, and have been practicing ancient Jewish customs for hundreds of years. We need your help to make this vital life-saving outreach possible. Will you be a blessing to these wonderful people and the thousands of others in desperate need? The elderly, children, infants, and toddlers could die for lack of basic medical care. You can help save lives, but we must act now. Call or click right now to help us save lives. And with your gift of any amount, we'll say thank you by sending you a new and insightful resource by End Times expert, Dr. Ron Rhodes, 40 Days Through Daniel. The prophetic book of Daniel can oftentimes be challenging to understand. With Dr. Rhodes' book, he has simplified Daniel by breaking it down into 40 daily readings with easy-to-understand commentary on each verse. You'll be astonished as you start to see how prophecy is unfolding before our very eyes, how God's prophetic timeline is moving forward, and what it means for you. If God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $80 or more today to help bless some of the neediest people on earth, we'll send you the gift just mentioned and this beautiful woven tapestry featuring the Lion of the Tribe of Judah on a white Star of David. This tapestry, which is perfect for hanging in your living room or dining room, is a wonderful reminder that Yeshua, Jesus, is the mighty Lion who will protect, love, and bless His people. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this humanitarian aid and to help countless others around the globe, please call or click now. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call or click right now.
We're back with Dr. Ron Rhodes, who's written, I think, a fantastic book, must reading, 40 Days Through Daniel. I want to congratulate you. This is really hot off the press.
It is.
First time you've seen it.
It looks pretty good to me.
It looks terrific to me, and it's an amazing book. We're going to give this one away, but this is an amazing book packed with prophecy, and it talks about an abomination of desolation.
Right.
And if it's a future event, although it already took place, and that was a type or shadow, a temple, physical temple, has to be rebuilt. Ron, how is that going to happen?
Well, the big resistance today is the Muslims. That's the big resistance. That's where their mosque is and all
bigger
like that.
Bigger and bigger resistance.
That's right. But here's what I think is going to happen. The Ezekiel invasion involves a massive Muslim invasion into Israel that includes Iran and Sudan and Libya, all the nations around the Black and Caspian Seas, including Afghanistan and Kyrgyzstan and all those other stand nations. They're going to join in conjunction with Russia. And Israel will
stand. Which is being set up, by the way. Russia is now in the Middle East.
That's right.
Turkey is gaining momentum.
Turkey is
to
a big one,
you know,
Beth Togarma. And the fact is that with the alliances that presently exist between Russia and these Muslim nations, there will be this massive land invasion into Israel, and Israel will stand no chance of success. Will the United States be with Israel? No. Israel stands alone. But guess who defends Israel? Who is the apple of God's eye? It's Israel. God is watching out for Israel. And God utterly destroys the Muslim invaders and also rains fire down upon those who dwell securely on the coastlands.
God defending His people. He who keepeth Israel never slumbers
That's
nor
exactly
sleeps.
That's exactly right. Amen,
Love
brother.
That scripture.
And the fact is that the Muslims will be greatly weakened at that time. I believe that that's going to enable the rapid rebuilding of the temple. And that invasion could take place as much as 3.5 years before the tribulation even begins. And I talk about that in my book, Northern Storm
Rising.
So
it's
that's
an
a different
aftermath
thing.
Of war.
Yeah.
Israel's
the Muslim
looking
community
for peace.
Will be so weak that it will make it very easy for the Antichrist not only to sign a covenant with Israel, but for Israel to be able to rebuild its temple because the Muslim community has been so weakened as a result of God's judgment on Muslim countries.
Wow. we're seeing this divine, this scenario divinely being set up. It's
That's
just
right.
incredible.
And just,
and it's the frequency.
And think about it. How is it possible that the Antichrist false religion would come into being so quickly? Well, you've got the Muslim community that's already been taken out at the Ezekiel invasion. That's one community that would stand against this false religion of the Antichrist. And the church has already been raptured too.
Something
that's the other community
radically
that
has to change
it.
Because they will never allow, I don't believe a temple can be built on any other site. And
yeah.
the idea of it being alongside the Dome of the Rock, that's a really hard one if you've been
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
So something radically has to change. We only have a couple minutes left. I want to jump into two things. The profound statement that is made, that is given to Daniel to seal up the vision until a set time in history, the end of the age,
yeah.
when knowledge increases and people travel to and fro. Talk about that. I think that's a stunning statement.
Well, it is stunning. In fact, you know, knowledge has increased geometrically. Not, it's not just doubled. It's not tripled. It's not quadrupled. We're talking about a geometric increase in knowledge and travel as well. Who would have thought back in biblical times that we'd be flying all over planet Earth? And I think that one of the things about the sealing up also relates to the fact that we understand more about prophecy as we draw nearer to the time in which they will be fulfilled. You see, the Spirit of God moved upon the prophets' hearts to mouth these truths. But the Spirit of God also works in us to help us to understand what is written in Scripture. And the closer we draw to the end times, the more the Spirit is pouring out His wisdom on us so that we can understand what's taking place in the Middle East and all around the world. And so these are exciting times. It's not only a time for us to be discerning, but it's a time to be excited because our redemption draws near.
This is a wake-up call. I'm hearing a wake-up call.
Well, there is a wake-up call. Jesus chastised the Jewish leaders because they were not able to interpret the signs of the times. So I think that what God is calling us to do is to learn prophetic scripture so that we will be able to understand what the signs of the times are. And then I think God calls us to be accurate observers of the times so that when there are legitimate correlations between what's happening in the world and the signs of the times recorded in prophetic scripture, we'll know that we are in the end times, just as surely as leaves grow on a tree in the summertime.
How close are we, Ron? I'm not looking for a date, a prediction, but how close are we?
Well, I believe that we're getting very close because of what I call the convergence factor. We haven't just seen one prophecy be fulfilled, like the rebirth of Israel in 1948. We are seeing the convergence of multiple different prophecies, all converging at a point in the not-too-distant future. And we're seeing prophecies, the stage being set for prophecies to be fulfilled during the tribulation period. Now, if the tribulation period is drawing near, how much nearer is the rapture of the church? You know, inquiring minds want to know.
Yes, I have one last, I have so many things I want to ask you, but one last thing. The statement that Daniel makes that says, some who sleep in the dust, talking about a resurrection,
yes,
will resurrect to everlasting life, others to everlasting contempt.
Yes.
It's heaven and hell, clearly
it is
to
heaven
me.
And hell. I think for believers, you and I are going to get a body upgrade that has what I call permaflesh.
Hair?
No more hair falling out, no more heart disease, no more kidney disease, and we can still eat food, by the way. Jesus ate food four times in his resurrection body, so I'm looking forward to that good heavenly cooking. But on the other side, you've got a resurrection unto damnation, as the New Testament puts it. This is a resurrection where the wicked will, in their resurrection bodies, appear before the great white throne judgment. And the purpose of the great white throne judgment is not only to populate the lake of fire, but to determine degrees of punishment for those who are cast into it.
Dr. Rhodes' book, 40 Days Through Daniel, is must reading. It's an excellent resource for understanding the book of Daniel and making it part of your devotional life and getting on fire for God. Ron, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you very much. It was awesome. God bless you.
There's much more on Jewish Voice just ahead. We'll be right back.
Make a memory of a a lifetime by recommitting your love and renewing your vows on the Jewish Voice 2016 Passover on the Seas Caribbean Cruise. Join Rabbi Jonathan Bernis and his family April 16th through April 23rd and enjoy the beautiful white sand beaches and tranquil turquoise waters of St. Martin, St. Thomas, and Nassau, Bahamas on one of the world's newest and largest luxury cruise liners. It's the perfect place to not only celebrate the miracle of Passover, but to rededicate your marriage to each other and to God. The rededication of marriage vows will be officiated by Rabbi Jonathan Bernis under a traditional Jewish kippah, the marriage canopy. You will also receive a beautiful certificate validating your continued commitment to each other, and the event will continue with a festive reception and formal dinner. Don't miss out on the perfect opportunity to share something meaningful with your loved one. Call 1-888-435-3787 or go to jewishvoice.org/Passover and renew your vows on the 2016 Passover on the Seas Caribbean Cruise.
Jewish Voice has a mandate. It's found in Romans 1:16 to proclaim the good news of Jesus as Messiah to the world, to the Jew first, and also to the nations. We travel around the globe providing life-saving medical aid, dental care, eye care, even eye surgeries to Jewish people and their neighbors in desperate need. And often in the course of helping someone else, we end up being blessed ourselves. Recently, I traveled to Israel and I met a group of Holocaust survivors whose amazing stories of survival deeply touched me, and I think they'll touch you as well. Take a look.
Can you talk specifically about the people that need our help?
Maria, she's from Ashdod. What was the most significant I found out is an endless loneliness.
To w szkole było, da?
Da. A tu każe, ja języka nie znaju, niczego nie maju. Nie nauczyła się, byłaby nauczyła się, mój pani, ja, хорошу pamięć mała.
Gdzie wy? Wy здесь?
Nie było 8 lat. Nas było 3 siostry i mama. Nas wygnali z domu. Чим було? Нічого не взяли. Загнали нас у Дністр. Така вода, мама нас так тримає догори. Одна умерла у нас 39-го року, середульша. Нас дві осталося. Мама нас тримає догори, вони стріляють по голові. Ми кричимо, плачемо, пищимо, мама. А коли вже вони переходили. Ой, це його воля, не наша. Я тепер дуже благословила в п'ятницю. Кажу, Боже, я тобі дякую, що ти мене навідуєш. Не буду я слаба, ти мене випробовуєш. Чи я буду нарікати на тебе, чи я буду казати зле на тебе, чи я буду тебе просити. Я тобі дякую, що ти мене навідуєш.
Many of these survivors endured imprisonment in the worst conditions imaginable. Yet here in the twilight of their lives, many remain little more than prisoners in their own homes, with barely enough to pay their expenses. They remain shut in, surrounded by little more than their memories. They may have come home to the land of promise, but most remain strangers in a strange land, unable to understand or speak Hebrew. Ironically, the very same strength and resilience that helped them survive the horrors of the Holocaust now keeps them from asking for help.
Потому что люди грамотные, люди цивилизованные, и они понимают грань между гордостью и нищетой. Я уже сказал вам, что среди нас есть такие люди, которые умрут, но не попросят.
I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
How long do we have to help these people? How much time is left?
We lose every second. During our conversation, few Holocaust survivors have died.
Every 45 minutes, a Holocaust survivor passes away. That's an average of 33 a day, over 230 per week, 1,000 each month. Within 10 years, they will all have disappeared.
We're committed to helping these Holocaust survivors in the final years of their lives. We only have about a decade left, maybe less, and then they'll all be gone. You can help us to make an impact on their lives and to share God's love with these people that have suffered so much and they've lived to tell about it. For more information on what you can do to help, you can contact us at the number on your screen or go to jewishvoice.tv.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming Messiah to the world, to the Jew first, and also to the nations. One key way we do this is by providing life-saving humanitarian aid to some of the poorest people in the world. In helping them, we share God's love and the good news of Yeshua, Jesus. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Barangwa, Zimbabwe, the Lemba. This faithful yet forgotten people have ties to the ancient people of Israel, the priestly tribe of Aaron, and have been practicing ancient Jewish customs for hundreds of years. We need your help to make this vital life-saving outreach possible. Will you be a blessing to these wonderful people and the thousands of others in desperate need? The elderly, children, infants, and toddlers could die for lack of basic medical care. You can help save lives, but we must act now. Call or click right now to help us save lives. And with your gift of any amount, we'll say thank you by sending you a new and insightful resource by end times expert, Dr. Ron Rhodes, 40 Days Through Daniel. The prophetic book of Daniel can oftentimes be challenging to understand. With Dr. Rhodes' book, he has simplified Daniel by breaking it down into 40 daily readings with easy-to-understand commentary on each verse. You'll be astonished as you start to see how prophecy is unfolding before our very eyes, how God's prophetic timeline is moving forward, and what it means for you. If God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $80 or more today to help bless some of the neediest people on earth, we'll send you the gift just mentioned and this beautiful woven tapestry featuring the Lion of the Tribe of Judah on a white Star of David. This tapestry, which is perfect for hanging in your living room or dining room, is a wonderful reminder that Yeshua, Jesus, is the mighty Lion who will protect, love, and bless His people. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share a gift in support of this humanitarian aid and to help countless others around the globe, please call or click now. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call or click right now.
A big thank you to Dr. Ron Rhodes for joining us all this week to discuss his latest book, 40 Days Through Daniel. I want to thank you also for watching today and remind you, as I do in every program, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Psalm 122:6 promises to prosper those who love Israel and pray for Israel. So if you want to prosper, pray for Israel this week. Until next time, this is Jonathan Burness saying shalom and God bless you. Thank you.